we thought that it was the safest route. And on that note, we also would encourage you, at the end of this service, we are going to have a reception up in the convent. And I've asked Sister Hannah to go to the top of the ramp to greet people up there to make flow out of here, so to get to that reception. And so we don't just congregate in here. All the food's up there, so there's your drawing card. Please, if you have a cell phone, silence it now. We are going to record this. For nice reading, right? That's why I handed out Kleenex and cough drops. Does anybody else need them? Because we would. You need it?
Yeah, I just need a cough drop.
Also, if you are not used to this house, if you need to go to a restroom, if you go into the convent, go towards the staircase that goes to the second floor, turn around. There's a bathroom right there, and there's a bathroom at the end of that hall. If you go all the way across. Okay, cough drops, please. Communion. Because of this crowd, we do not have as many chalices, sorry. And that's the way we've been doing it over here. So we will, you can there again. Okay, I'll just stand away from you. The readers and anybody at the altar will be doing that too, by the way. But we thought they had enough distance. We will only be receiving communion in one time, just the bread this morning. Because we don't have enough chalices, but for those of you that may not know this, if you receive the bread, you receive communion. It's the full communion. You don't need to receive both kinds. It's just, we're pagans and we like both. And we will come up in a single line, but this is the order. The organist,
and maybe the photographer, I don't know.
Yeah. The front row will be communicating. You don't have to move. Just stay where you are. Mother Julie will come to you. And then we'll start from the back. So Chuck and Carolyn, you'll be the first ones. Come up here. Come up on this side. Turn around in the aisles and just go back to your seats that way. Please don't try to go this way and go around. You just stumble all over everybody and you don't want anyone having an accident. Okay. The booklet that you have on your seat or in your hand now. The front page has the order of service. It has all your page numbers, everything you need there. You will need the prayer book if you follow the prayer book. It has the page number there. But this is what you refer to. You don't have it interested like you normally do. And everything that you need other than the prayer book is in this. Okay, in order. Okay. Sister Hannah at the top of the ramp and reception. I think that's everything except for one thing. Please, after you receive after you partake of the food, spread out. Don't just clump in the dining room or in the music room where all the food is. You can go into the living room, all over the place. I don't care. You know, just not just the bedroom. Not to the second floor. But. We want everybody to be safe, and that's if you're in small groups, it's better than if everybody is clumped together. Yes. At the end of the service, don't move. all of this service is being live streamed. I don't know if you know it or not, but this is Religious Life Sunday, and we want everybody in the Episcopal Church, and everybody else for that matter, to know that we have religious orders. And so we are taking the whole thing, and we are taking a group photo, I think from here, is that right?
Yes.
Yes. So if you'll just stay where you are, we will have a group photo with everybody present, and we will put that on Facebook to let everybody know about this celebration. Anything else? Is that it? Brown cover. Great. Thank you.
be thy kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God,
God. say in unison Psalm 27, found on page 617 in your prayer book, verse 1 and verses 5 through 13.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom then shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom then shall I be afraid? One thing have I asked of the Lord, one thing I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the fair beauty of the Lord, and to seek him in his temple. For in the day of trouble he shall keep me safe in his shelter. He shall hide me in the secrecy of his dwelling, and set me high upon a rock. Even now he lifts up my head above my enemies round about me. Therefore I will offer in his dwelling an oblation with sounds of great gladness. I will sing and make music to the Lord. Hearken to my voice, O Lord, when I call. Have mercy on me and answer me. You speak in my heart and say, seek my face. Your face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not your face from me, nor turn away your servant in displeasure. You have been my helper. Cast me not away. Do not forsake me, O God of my salvation.
A reading from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. Now I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that of all of you be in agreement, and that there be no divisions among you, but that you be united in the same mind and the same purpose. For it has been reported to me by Chloe's people that there are quarrels among you, my brothers and sisters. What I mean is that each of you says, I belong to Paul, or I belong to Apollos, or I belong to Cephas, or I belong to Christ. Has Christ been divided? Was Paul crucified for you? Or were you baptized in the name of Paul? I thank God that I baptized none of you except Crispus and Gaius, so that no one can say that you were baptized in my name. I did baptize also the household of Stephanas. Beyond that, I do not know whether I baptized anyone else. For Christ did not send me to baptize, but to proclaim the gospel, and not with eloquent wisdom, so that the cross of Christ might not be emptied of its power. For the message about the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. Here ends the reading.
Thank you. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Now when Jesus heard that John had been arrested, he withdrew to Galilee. He left Nazareth and made his home in Capernaum by the sea in the territory of Zebulun and Naphtali, so that what had been spoken through the prophet Isaiah might be fulfilled. Land of Zebulun, land of Naphtali, on the road by the sea across the Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles. The people who sat in darkness have seen a great light, and for those who sat in the region and shadow of death, light has dawned. From that time, Jesus began to proclaim, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near." As he walked by the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew, his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And he said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fish for people." Immediately they left their nets and followed him. And as he went there, he saw two other brothers, James, son of Zebedee, mending, and his brother John in the boat with their father Zebedee, mending their nets. And he called them. Immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him. Jesus went throughout Galilee, teaching in their synagogue, and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom, and curing every disease and every sickness among the people. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
You in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The institution and blessing of a new prioress is an occasion of great joy for this community and for its friends, associates, and oblates, as well as an occasion, I would guess, of some anxiety for Sister Hannah and her sisters. So it must have been for Peter and Andrew, James and John, when Jesus called them from their fishing nets, "Follow me. Follow me," is the word Jesus throws out with a stronger net than any they had ever handled. A net that would pull these men towards him for life, for death, forever. How wonderful to be called by Jesus in this singular way. How elating. How scary. Aside from the promise that from now on they would be fishing for people, whatever that meant, these brand new disciples could have no real sense of what lay ahead for them. It was really uncharted territory. This is not quite uncharted territory for you, Sister Hannah. After all, you have lived in this community for many years, and your sisters recognize you now as their senior sister. A designation that has more to do with spiritual and other gifts than with chronological age. You have lived faithfully under another faithful prioress, Sister Madeline Mary, and you have learned from her words and example. And even, as we all learn from our elders, from her mistakes. You have learned and will continue to draw wisdom from the centuries of monastic life and witness that have gone before you. Jesus, speaking through your sisters, believes you are ready to follow this call, to follow him in this new way. You have been following Jesus for a very long time, and you know you can trust him now, too, as you begin this new chapter together. Today, as Sister Madeline Mary mentioned, it is designated as Religious Life Sunday in the Episcopal Church, an occasion to hold before the church the distinctive witness of monastic and religious communities. All Christians, of course, live into their baptisms, their deep union with Christ in his death and resurrection. Not in the abstract, but in the day-to-day flesh and blood ways they engage in their particular and manifold vocations. Married people live Christ one way, single people another way, and vowed religious still another way. And even then, religious communities across the church show a marvelous diversity according to the distinct charisms and vision of their founders. Some communities, often enclosed, give themselves up largely to prayer and contemplation, glorifying God and interceding for the world. Still others are mostly engaged in active service outside their walls. And still others embody a mixed life, striving to blend a rich life of prayer and fidelity to communal recitation of the offices with service to the church and the world. The community of St. Mary, taking its inspiration from the rule of St. Benedict, is of this third type, I think. Yet one charism or gift of the Holy Spirit is essential to them all. And this is the greatest gift, the gift of charity or love. Love is the hallmark of God's presence and power. And in religious life, as no doubt in all Christian life, this love is shown above all in the relations of community members to one another. Only from that heart of love beating within the community itself can any authentic love be shown to others beyond it. No doubt this is what so distressed St. Paul about the reports he heard from Chloe's people. The Corinthian church had degenerated into factions, rival parties, each with their own slogans and leaders. I'm for Apollos. We belong to Paul, or the coup de grace. We belong to Christ. Factions and cliques and the vice of party spirit undermine the gospel. Paul goes on to explain that his own self-presentation is not that of a charismatic leader. He doesn't preach the gospel, he reminds them, with words that might bowl them over with eloquent wisdom. Because, he explains, such self-display would put him at the center of attention and loyalty rather than Christ, and Christ crucified at that. For Christ crucified manifests the true power and wisdom of God. The connection here between a community's loving regard for one another, leadership grounded in Christ, and the wisdom of the cross is subtle but real. Love within any community will quickly collapse into sentimentality, then slide into cynicism without the strong tonic of the cross. Christian love requires self-abnegation, and the higher one travels up a hierarchy, the deeper must be the self-sacrifice, putting the common good before one's personal preferences. Hence, in the blessing of a new prioress, she is first assured of her community's election to leadership, and in the next breath, the officiant prays that she will be a good servant, following the example of our Lord Jesus Christ. She takes on the heavy responsibility of guiding the community with wisdom, vision, and patience, and sensitive listening is specifically named. Attentive listening always requires us to place our own agenda aside, at least for a while, to enter with imagination and sympathy into the concern of the other. In any healthy community, of course, there will be differences of opinion and perspective. And in a mature, self-confident community, such an airing of views, when needed and called upon at the right moment, can enrich common decision making. This is only a threat to communal harmony if we are unwilling to grant good faith on the part of those with whom we disagree, or if we harbor resentments when we don't get our own way. And so Saint Benedict counsels his own community, prefer nothing to the love of Christ. And herein lies the distinctive witness of religious life. It is emphatically centered in Christ. Psalm 27 speaks of the overwhelming attraction towards God. You speak in my heart and say, "Seek my face. Your face, Lord, will I seek." We find the face of Christ, along with others in the household of the church. And for vowed religious, That household is focused with searing intensity in the prayer-centered monastic community. One thing I have asked of the Lord, one thing I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the fair beauty of the Lord, and to seek him in his temple. The love of each member for our Lord is the never-failing wellspring of love by which they may offer kindness, forgiveness, and patience to each other in the daily rub of community living. The obvious sacrifices of living the vowed life of obedience, celibate chastity, and the relinquishment of personal property, holding all material things in common, such sacrifices are only possible because one has fallen in love with Jesus and heard the call, "Follow me," to mean this life with this particular community. When a monastic community loves Jesus, and in that love, love one another, they become a magnet. People are simply drawn to them, want to be near them, hope to discover their secret of joy. I think this is one reason monastics were the great evangelists of Northern Europe in the early Middle Ages. People saw in their communal life what gospel living looked like, and it was immensely attractive. Suwannee, an Episcopal foundation from its earliest days, is a natural home for an Episcopal monastic community. Here in Suwannee, we should see something of the variety of possible vocations in the church, sustaining and reinforcing one another. We pray that you, the community of St. Mary, will flourish in your life together and attract new sisters. The Epiphany season we are in now focuses on mission, on proclaiming the good news of Christ's salvation, as our collect says, that we and the whole world might perceive his marvelous works. Sister Hannah, may you and this community heed Christ's call and be his light, so that all of us may shine even more with you in the radiance of his light.
believe in one God,
the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people are Form 3 on page 387. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
O God, whose blessed Son became poor, that we through his poverty might be rich, deliver us from an inordinate love of this world, that we, inspired by the devotion of those who live the religious life, may serve you with singleness of heart and attain to the riches of the age to come, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways.
Holy Spirit keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Following the example of our Lord Jesus Christ, may you be a good servant to those among whom you will live and work. May you seek the guidance of the Holy Spirit in all you do and say. May you strive to be a good and sensitive listener to those whom you will seek to guide in the life and tradition of the community. May God give you wisdom, vision, and patience in making decisions related to this ministry. And now may God, who calls the community to this venture, be your comfort and encouragement always.
Amen.
Sister Hannah, are you willing to assume responsibility for this work in the community?
I am willing, the Lord being my helper.
Let us pray. Most loving God, you call us to your service and give us the grace to do your will. Give to Sister Hannah the strength needed to carry out the mission now entrusted to her, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
Amen.
Thank you.
and also with you.
You taught us to hope for salvation. Father, you love the world so much that in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son to be our Savior, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He lived as one of us, yet without sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners, freedom, to the sorrowful, joy. To fulfill your purpose, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the grave, destroyed death and made the whole creation new. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose for us, he sent the Holy Spirit, his own first gift for those who believe, to complete his work in the world and to bring to fulfillment the sanctification of all. When the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, his heavenly Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. At supper with them, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Father, we now celebrate this memorial of our redemption, recalling Christ's death and his descent among the dead, proclaiming his resurrection and ascension to your right hand, awaiting his coming in glory, and offering to you from the gifts you have given us this bread and this cup. We praise you and we bless you.
We praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, Lord our God.
Lord, we pray that in your goodness and mercy, the Holy Spirit may descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be holy gifts for your holy people, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that all who share this bread and cup may become one body and one spirit, a living sacrifice in Christ, to the praise of your name. Remember, Lord, your one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, redeemed by the blood of your Christ. Reveal its unity, guard its faith, and preserve it in peace. Remember John, Bishop of this diocese, and all who minister in your church. Remember all your people, and those who seek your truth. Remember Sister Hannah and the community of St. Mary. Remember all who have died in the peace of Christ and those whose faith is known to you alone. Bring them into the place of eternal joy and light. And grant that we may find our inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, with patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and all the saints who have found favor with you in ages past. We praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty God and Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
gifts of God for the people of God.
Thank you.
eternal God, heavenly Father.
You have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
May Christ, the Son of God, be manifest in you, that your lives may be a light to the world. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you today and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the photo. Yeah.